Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijja, a retired lecturer of Metrology preaching Christianity, render exposition 1 Corinthians 8, verse 1 to 13. Now, as touching things offered unto idols, we know that we all have knowledge of God, which is living. Idols are dead. Knowledge puffeth up, but charity edifieth. That means knowledge puffeth up, but charity, you know, philanthropy, edify it. And if any man think that he knoweth anything, he knoweth nothing yet as he ought to know. So one should not be puffed up that I know everything, but one should stay humble and listen to everybody. And what is good, keep it. What is not good, throw it out. But if any man love God, the same is known of him. So if you love God, then you are known to the God that you love him, not to the men. As concerning therefore the eating of those things that are offered in sacrifice unto idols, we know that an idol is nothing in the world, and that there is none other God but one. So we know, you know, this is the age of God, in which you have to worship one God, which we call Allah, or you can call Akal Purakh, Ram, and so many names they are in the world, or so many. For though there be that are called gods, whether in heaven or in earth. So the gods are the one which represent the mythological persons. So this, our physical body, is mythology, is not reality. Our inner self is reality. So gods pertain to our physical self. As there be gods many and lords many. So in gods, you know, you have many gods and many lords over you. But our Father is not a lord. He is our loving and merciful Father who sets us free. But to us there is but one God, the Father, of whom are all things, and we in him, and one our anointed brother Christ Jesus, and not the Lord Jesus Christ of the Antichrist, by whom are all things, and we by him. So our stake is Christ Jesus, and he is our stake and support. So in we go up in to honor him, because he has given us this knowledge. Howbeit, there is not in every man that knowledge, for some with conscience of the idol unto this hour eat it as a thing offered unto an idol. So some people have only, being simpleton or once born, they can only have the conception of idols. So they believe them and they eat offered to them, and their conscience being weak is defiled. So it's defiled because the idols are not the real God. But meat commendeth us not to God, for neither if we eat are we the better, neither if we eat not are we the worse. So whether we eat, you know, or not eat what is offered to idols and other things, it doesn't make any difference. It is your own conscience which that works. But take heed lest by any means this liberty of yours become a stumbling block to them that are weak. So you have to encourage people. So if they eat of the idols, that things offered to idols, food offered to idols, don't be a stumbling block to them. You eat with them, and slowly you tell them what is the reality and real Father our, which is God, that idols are not real God. For if any man see thee which hast knowledge, sit at meat in the idol's temple, shall not the conscience of him which is weak be emboldened to eat those things? That means they would be encouraged, you know, that they should also eat the offering made to the idols. So, which are offered to idols. So then if somebody who is a knowledgeable, you know, who has the knowledge of God, that means who is a twice born person, if he sits and eat meat in the idol's temple, then he encourages the other one also. He makes them strong. And through thy knowledge shall the weak brother perish. So the weak brother will not then think of improving. He will be happy because you are eating, so why not he should be eating there? For whom Christ died. Christ never died because he was never born. It was Jesus who was born, it was Jesus who died on the cross. Christ stand for the Word of God that was in the beginning and is forever. But when ye sin so against the brethren and wound their weak conscience, ye sin against Christ. Now this is corruption over here, that you can't sin against Christ. So sin is a transgression of the moral laws. When the bishop became corrupt, they just subdued the people under the notion of sin. Sin, the moral laws of Moses, is the transgression is a sin. So transgression against the Holy Spirit, that means what is in your heart and what you say from your mouth is different. That is called blasphemy. So in Christ or in God, it is the blasphemy that count, not the sin. So sin is we have taken the sting of this sin forever in Christ Jesus. Wherefore, if meat make my brother to offend, I will eat no flesh while the word standeth, lest I make my brother to offend. So if you know somebody doesn't eat meat because it involves the killing of the animal, and if he is a vegetarian and if he doesn't like meat, then we should not eat meat in front of him or in the company of him, as he would be offended. So it's no good to offend anybody, but try to have peace with your brethren. So here Christ Jesus gives you, St. Paul gives you what you should eat or what you should not eat. So if we eat what is presented to the idols, knowingly that idols are not living gods, they are dead gods of the dead people. Remember Christ Jesus said, let the dead bury their dead. So these were the people who were dead, that they go to the temple and they worship these idols, not knowing that they are dead gods. The living God is within our heart, and sometimes people don't bother about that. And this is worshipped, the living God in our heart is worshipped through truth and in spirit. So that's what Christ Jesus told the Samaritan woman at the well, that in this age God is worshipped in truth and in spirit, not in the temple here or there. So God is everywhere. God bless you.